simple view of what cryptography is actually all about. So let's get there. Let's now look underneath the hood of something.
String. There is no string.
There's no such thing as a string. We're doing a deliberate, but I think an effective abstraction here.
Yeah, yeah. I think it's a good incarnation of exactly that, because I think we would very quickly get lost in the weeds if we introduced char star and pointers and all of that so early in the semester. So this is just a one-liner in the CS50 library. We type def string to just char star so that we don't have to talk about it at that low level for a few weeks.
But by this point, we're now starting to introduce the concepts of arrays, and we can talk about collections of information. Yeah.
Any student can appreciate that, right? Like, a string is just what we'll call an array, back to back, and you have the nice square bracket notation to manipulate it, and that's it.
But you don't have to get stuck in, like you said, like pointers or see a char star and have to use that all the time. It's nice to have something just that feels different. A character is a word, a character is a letter, a string is a word. These are two different things, even though eventually we're going to see they're really just they're similar, and they're much more similar than they might first appear.
And it's nice because you can then get to the core of what it means to be a string ultimately, that once we start talking about memory and what's beyond the A in Zamyla, the second A in Zamyla, like what is actually there terminating the string and keeping it from flowing into some other name or some other string that's also there in memory. And there too, I mean, even in week two, I'm sort of inclined already to want to talk about memory, because at the end of the day, we're going to find that that is by far the most effective, I think, and ultimately accessible way of explaining these higher level abstractions is just take away the abstraction and show what's actually there. I certainly don't think it's beyond students even just a few weeks into the class.
It is strange though that C, you know, a lot of modern languages kind of blur the line between a character and a string. So it's strange that C doesn't have this at all. It might surprise people to know that string is not a native data type.
Yeah, indeed. If you want it, you have to build it yourself, pretty much. And then in here, I'm going to do string s gets get